Hello YouTube, this is Oscar right here. I just wanted to make a video about upgrading Horizon View 7.7 to the newest version, which is 7.8. I read about the new features. Most enhancements have been done to the HTML5 management console. Since then, they're trying to get away from the Flash web console. So we're gonna start and see if Horizon 7.8 is gonna be supported on my current lab. So we have, right now we're running the version I'm running is the version 6.7 update 1b, and we're gonna see if it's supported by our Horizon 7. So we go to the interoperability matrix. This is the version that we're gonna install, all the versions of vCenter, and it is supported. So what we're gonna do next is we're gonna take a snapshot so our connection servers and composer and back up our databases. So I will back up my, first of all, I need to disable the composer provisioning. So at the moment I don't have any link clones or instant clone pools. The only thing I have is this farm. What I'll do, I just disable provision for now to be safe. Once I do that, I'm gonna go back up my composer database. We'll give it a date. So. That has been completed. Now we're gonna take a snapshot of our composer. Now we're going to log into our connection server. Cancel. Yes. Not connection server, composer. Okay, here we go. We have connection server, composer. We're going to accept. see if we run into any issues, and if we do, we're gonna try to resolve them. Alright, to the password. We are gonna use an existing we're finished. We're gonna reboot. And we're gonna check our connection server administrator console to see if it got upgraded to the latest. Okay. Still booting. Let's give it a few seconds. Okay, so it's probably gonna take a few seconds for the service to start. And it already started, so no problems detected. We see that we have version 7.8, so we can close now the connection, the composer server. We'll do the jump server. This is my jump server. We'll do this at the end. Right. Now I will do the composer. So this is a replicated environment. The view composer, this is my master view composer, and I have my replica over here. So we're gonna take a snapshot. Composer one. We're not gonna take a virtual memory snapshot, we're just gonna take a regular one. And pre-upgrade. Okay. And I'm gonna do the same one with the replica. Snapshot. But before we do that, I am going to back up now both. And I also like to do it manually, so files, VMware, view server, tools and bin. So we're gonna do a backup of the LDAP database. It's SVDM export exe and call it lda.pack.ldf. Oh, I have to run this as an administrator. Should have known that. Okay. And we're gonna try again. So vdm export ldf. Okay, and it's right here. I'm gonna put it right on my desktop. Okay, that's done. So one of the requirements for the installation is that you have to have the Microsoft .NET Framework version 6.1 at least. And so it looks like I don't have it, but we're gonna run it to see what happens. Okay, this upgrade includes changes to the authentication login as the current user will no longer work. Okay. Then we install it. This is a server. Oh, I do have it installed here. Well, I have 4.5. says that I need Microsoft.NET Framework 2 version 6.1. Otherwise, I will fail. I guess you have version 4.7 then. Yes, I do have it. Just had to check. I was looking in the wrong place. Okay, so I completed. We're gonna click finish. Give it some time. And I will check my console one more time. Probably gonna look me up. Refresh. A few minutes. Okay, so let's verify. Yep, 7.8. So we're making some progress, no issues. We're gonna do the same thing with this connection server. As an administrator, yes. VMware. Like to copy this, paste it. Oh. Now we run our VDM export and we're gonna call it LDF. Make sure, yeah. Paste on my desktop, just have it handy. Okay. Next. Okay, we already know that. That's on the release notes. And we install. All right, finally completed. Finished. You know what? I'm going to see what the new HTML console looks like. Okay. Okay, it looks very similar to the previous one, to the 7.7, so they added more functionality to this console, so that's the major update I believe that they did. And now we're gonna update our jump server. So I will do the same. Got this, take a snapshot. Alright, so it's saying that it's detected another version. We're gonna check. And yes, there's another version which was installed last year and is 1.2.0.6.7.3. Click OK. Okay. All right. And install it. Let's hope it doesn't fail.